Hey everyone, this is going to be my board review for the Pump Cat. I was aching to be somewhere near your voice, was all I heard. I was shaking from a storm in me, haunted by the specters that we had to see. Yeah, I wanted to be the melody above the noise, above the hurt. I was young, not dumb, just wishing to be blinded by you, brand new. And we were my name is Kikwo, and I am one of the shapers for Red Manta. Right, yeah, Red Manta foil boards. This is a design that I came up with. I call it the Pump Cat just because the whole concept behind this design was to help me pump a little easier. I'm not super in shape, so any little bit can help. And I don't have a high aspect wing, or I don't have a really big 30 something inch wing. Right now I'm riding the X28 from Cloud9. It's a decent sized wing. I can still pump back out maybe about two waves back from the wave that I hop off of. But I see everybody pumping around in circles with their high aspects and their big giant wings. So I kind of wanted to stay on the smaller wing around the 28 inch size, but yet see if I could alter the board to see if I can pump like the other guys. So that was the whole design behind this board. This board that I made is a 4'6", 19.5 wide by about...
It's 6:04 somewhere at the beach house, right here.
It's 6:04 somewhere. That's right, at the beach house by 6:04, Westside's new beach spot at the Waianae Army Rest Camp, Waterfront Sunset Dining, Banquet Hall for any events, private parties, and team fundraisers. Enjoy our aloha hours, 2 to 4 p.m. daily. Half off select poo-poos and draft beers. 16 beers on draft, voted Hawaii's best Bloody Mary. Live music and friendly staff. See your Instagram music lineup and specials. It's 6:04 somewhere.
It's 6:04 somewhere. At the beach house, right here.
3/4 on the thickest part, and in the tail, which is where all the changes were really made, I got it down to almost about 2 inches. So I gotta show you guys the bottom. Front half, simple, flat with V. The tail, that's where it gets tricky. If you look close, this way, right around here. From here, this is about the mid of the board, right where I made this color tape off. So right around here, I've got it sloping down towards the tail area. But here, of course, it's going to be flat so that we can so that the foil plate mount has somewhere flat to sit. So that I've got it flat. So I've got it basically sloping down into this area. I kept the thickness of the rail, like you can see right there. To see how thick it is, but I tried to keep the thickness of the rails, which to me makes it kind of look like a catamaran. If anyone knows what a catamaran boat looks like, it's kind of got that double hull look to it. That's kind of where I got the name Pump Cat from. But I've been riding this board for about 2 weeks now, and it's actually been pretty good. Definitely I can feel the difference of this area, my back foot being much more sensitive and the foil being more sensitive to when I'm pushing down. So with that said, it definitely helps me fly a little easier, pump a little less hard because it's a lot more sensitive to my back foot pushing down on the foil. So there's a few changes that I could probably make, but overall, this was a good change and this is probably a change that I'm gonna stick with. Definitely, I think it's something in the right direction as far as pumping and the concept of having less foam, less stringer in between your foot, which would be here, and the foil, which would be coming out here. Having less foam in between your foot and the foil
there should be less energy loss when you push down. I think if the tail of this board was about 6 inches thick, all that EPS foam in between, all that stringer in between, you're gonna try and push down, and you're not gonna, hear that the energy from your foot is gonna be absorbed into that foam. It has to transfer down into the mass of the foil, down to the wing, and it's gonna lose a lot of energy. So we've seen videos on Instagram with guys at the lakes putting foils on top of skim boards, on top of skateboards. Skateboards are, we all know, is super thin, and I mean they look extremely sensitive to the pumping, and guys can, it looks like they can pump super easy on those things. So that's where I kind of got the idea from. Like I said, I've been riding it for about 2 weeks now. Feels good. I can feel the difference from my older board that I used to ride that was much thicker in the tail. I'm gonna probably do a couple more modifications on my next board, and hopefully I can fine tune this baby into something really, really good. But if you have any other questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I'll get back to you and I'll answer your questions as soon as I can. And thanks for checking out the Pumpcat. Red Manta.